Matthias asks, why is the nonce, N-O-N-C-E, nonce, so small in this Bitcoin block? It's my understanding miners tried to get a valid block hash just by changing a 32-bit value called the nonce, 2 to the 32 possible values, or about 4.3 times 10 to the 9th. So that's basically 4 billion. The hash rate of an Antminer S9 is advertised to be 14 terahashes. So that's 14 times 10 to the 12. If I divide those numbers, it only takes 0.0003 seconds for a small miner to go through all the possible nonce values, a third of a millisecond. So I'm missing something here. Doing some research on this, I found that miners use hacks like end time rolling, which means changing the timestamp on the block. Another way is to try different Coinbase messages, which is an astronomical amount of possibilities. Not really astronomical. You can only use part of the Coinbase to do that, and people use that as what's called an extra nonce, for exactly the reasons you described. 32 bits can be cycled by a modern miner in a third of a millisecond. So you need another source of entropy to inject into the header of the block. And the Coinbase and the timestamp are two other options. What is the reason to have a small, seemingly insignificant nonce value? Why bother with end time rolling if there are so many more combinations available in the Coinbase message anyway? So there is a lot of considerations that go into this. The first one is, what is the reason to have a small, seemingly insignificant nonce value? What Matthias is saying here is, why 32 bits? 32 bits only gives you 4 billion combinations. And here's the thing you have to realize. When Bitcoin was built, the idea of ASICs wasn't on anybody's minds. The idea that this would be successful, drive a profitable industry, create an entire manufacturing sector, and result in people using cutting-edge silicon manufacturing just to compete in this particular thing. And not just a bit, but we're now talking about tens of millions of ASICs out there. And so 32 bits seemed like enough. It obviously wasn't. Because of the difficulty of changing the block header format, that would require a hard fork. It would be a very controversial hard fork. And because of that, we're stuck with 32 bits. So miners go elsewhere to find entropy, the ability to inject entropy into the header. Here's the thing, though. The header itself, which is 80 bytes, not all positions in the header are equal. There is a particular quirk in SHA-256 which allows a shortcut or optimization in the mid-state of SHA-256 called ASICBoost. You may have heard of this, but what it does is it allows you to calculate a mid-state that allows you to do a more efficient calculation of the SHA-256 of the header in such a way as to reduce energy consumption by about 20%. And a lot of that is done by changing the merkle tree in the block header. And some of that is by changing the Coinbase. So there's covert ASICBoost and overt ASICBoost. And it depends on which part of the header you're changing, because you can't do it everywhere. You have to do it in a specific part of the header. So that's why the Coinbase string is used. That's why end time rolling is used. And that's why the transactions are reordered in order to shuffle the merkle root of the transaction merkle tree. So all of these tricks are basically necessary because we don't have enough consensus to change the block header. There have been a number of proposals to change the block header, and those are still, you know, on the table. And at some point we may see a hard fork that makes some useful and important structural changes to the block header that makes it a lot easier for people to optimize their mining equipment in order to have a bigger, more simple nonce that can be cycled properly, to make ASICBoost legit by incorporating a special section in the header that allows people to use ASICBoost overtly without messing with a Coinbase or the block version number, or some of the other places they introduce entropy. We may see those things come to play, but nobody knows. Adam asks, unknown block versions are being mined. It's possible unknown rules are in effect. When I run my Bitcoin Core node, I see this message, warning, unknown block versions being mined, it's possible unknown rules are in effect. I've read a tweet by Luke Dasher that this is a result of miners violating the Bitcoin protocol, typically in their overt usage of the ASICBoost exploit. What does that mean, and should I be concerned? Really, no, you shouldn't be concerned. What this means is that miners are using the block version field within the block header in order to create more possible permutations of the block hash. And the most likely use for that is in order to take advantage of ASICBoost. There are a couple of different ways to take advantage of ASICBoost. An ASICBoost is basically a shortcut in the SHA-256 algorithm that allows for mining at a maybe up to 20% less energy use for the same number of hashes. And so ASICBoost is being used by a lot of miners in order to reduce their energy cost. It's an advantage, it's a competitive advantage. It can significantly affect the bottom line, the profitability of a miner. And so ASICBoost is being used, and when ASICBoost is being used, because of the particular structure of the block header and the way this shortcut in SHA-256 works, they need to change some bits in some part of the header in order to take advantage of ASICBoost. And given that there are not necessarily that many places where you can make changes in the block header without it affecting the outcome, they'll use the block version. And your Bitcoin node will complain about this because Bitcoin nodes are using the block version to try to figure out if the consensus rules have changed. And this is from a time when the block version was used to signal various votes in the Bitcoin system, for example, for the adoption of various soft fork features or even hard fork features. So typically, your node simply ignores that. The warning you're getting is just to tell you that it's seeing a block version that seems to be saying something about the block, but it doesn't know what that means. And what it's seeing really is junk. It's seeing random bit changes in the block version, which don't actually mean new rules are in effect. It just means that ASICBoost is in use. You don't need to be concerned. You can ignore that message completely.